गुड मॉर्निंग, दिस इज कार्तिकेयन रामनाथन, सीनियर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ ज़ेबू शेयर एंड वेल्थ मैनेजमेंट प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन लास्ट वीक लिस्टेड आईपीओ 197 कम्युनिकेशंस लिमिटेड। सो दिस इज नॉर्मली कॉल्ड एज पेटीएम। मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन इन दिस आईपीओ, दिस आईपीओ इज हैविंग अ वेरी गुड रेस्पॉन्स बिटवीन दट फिनेंशियल सर्विसेज कंपनी, बट इन रिटेल इज नॉट शोइंग मच मोर इंटरेस्ट इन दिस आईपीओ because the only criteria the company is making continuously loss in that, but their operation and then their entire thing is so good because the company has incorporated in the year 2000 and then after the March 31st 2021 this company has 333 millions of client base, almost which is around nearly 33 crores of client base across pan India. Okay, and then the 21 plus million registered merchants and then clients in this under this platform. So this is having a biggest market share also in this Indian financial mobile payment wallet, mobile wallet kind of things. So in the year 2009 this company has launched with a digital platform like a Paytm app, and then this company start providing that a cashless model. After that demonetization, this company got a very good rapport between the customers and the merchants. So the company started booming after that. So the company having a lot of potential to grow in market after the demonetization period. But the company is having a strong strength, competitive strength. And then the main important keynote point we need to look, the India's leading digital payment services platform, this company. Another one, strong brand identity with a brand value of $6.3 billion market share, and then large customer base with a 333 million total customers of 114 million annual transaction users and 21 million registered merchants which is actively available in this app. Another one, the Paytm super app access a wide range of digital payment services over mobile phones. So this is the most amazing and innovation product in this current financial ecosystem. So the company has listed in the last week that with the price band of 2080 rupees to 2150 rupees as a equity share price band. The 6 share is market lot. At the same initial day, the company has making a loss making of around, the company has make a big loss around nearly 20% on same day, listing day. And then the market has faced a low around nearly low of 1,271 rupees in this recent low. Nowadays the market is after that is taking some recovery, and then now the market has reached the high of 1,679 price. So the what are the lesson we have learned from this IPO? Because what is the reason behind this IPO loss making? But because the IPO not having much more subscription in retailer segment and then institutional investors also. First, the QIB investors, the subscription time around nearly 2.79, which is higher to across combined all thing. Another one is NII is subscription is very low, 0.24. And then RII subscription is 1.66 times. The total average is 1.89 times of subscription we have received. So this is very less subscription to compare with the other retail IPOs in market. So the subscription of the thing is played a vital role in this IPO market, because if the subscription is having a multiple times, nearly 50 times, 60 times, 100 times, then we can measure how much interest the public is showing against this IPO. So because this kind of lowest number, numeric digit, it shows the people not showing much more interest against this IPO. So first, after the IPO listing date, we need to take care of this. First day is November 8 is IPO opening date. November 10 is IPO closing date. So whenever the IPO is launched, we have to wait for the first 1 day or 2 days. So maximum, the final day morning, we have to take a decision, because based on the subscription only, we can take our decision accordingly. Because if the subscription numbers is higher, then we can start subscribing on this last day of the IPO, or else audience is not showing much more interest on this IPO, then we can reject this IPO based on the public strength. Though if the people is showing more interest, then the gray market premium will be increasing, then the demand will be created, so the IPO will be listed with at a very good premium price. So the reason behind for this IPO loss is due to the non-subscriber availability for this IPO. So the IPO is faced on more than a 40% to 45% loss making because of this reason only. So whenever the IPO launches, the company is having a very good rapport also between the customers and the client merchants and everything. The company is having a good market share also, not in a problem. But we have to look for that what are the interest and demands creating by the public. That is very important fact. So we have learned from the lesson from this company. Another one, the operation ratio of this company is continuously loss making. So that the people not showing much more interest on this IPO. So these are the two reasons behind this IPO loss making. So whenever you want to choose a good IPO, we have to look this parameter very clearly. So based on the audience subscription, we have to list it and we have to enroll on the last day of the IPO time. Okay, stay tuned. We have learned some lot of information about this in upcoming videos. We should have a happy trading. Thank you so much.